You want me to hunt in your place? Is that some kind of Banuk custom?
Perhaps it should be, but no. We survive and we prevail, until we fail to do either. I confess, this is not easy for me. For any other machine, I would die as I have lived. A Banuk hunter, weapon raised. But too many good lives have been lost to the claws. Throwing my old corpse atop the pile accomplishes nothing. Better to live in a world without the claws than to die while it still makes children orphans.
Sounds like you've got a reputation.
To be Banuk is to push your body to its limits. I've found my limits higher than most. Fearsome machines needed killing, and in my youth, I found I had a talent for killing them. Even now, my name carries such weight that when the claws beneath re-emerged, the Werak came to me.
Do you still have the same faith in yourself that your Werak seems to have?
Perhaps I did. Before I held my bow in shaking hands, noticed for the first time the spots on my knuckles. What a strange thing it is to be old. To stare backward and see such distance. But to stare forward at a looming wall.
This machine, the claws beneath. Why travel all the way to the cut just to hunt it?
Some songs. They include a refrain. The return of a past moment. It seemed fitting.
You've hunted this thing before.
Must have been 20 winters past. We were so close to bringing the claws to bay. Closer than anyone else ever got.
We?
Me. And my friend. He was a chieftain of my Werak then. A skilled hunter. Every few years, the claws would emerge in a new location. I knew of two chieftains he'd sent to their burial pyres. My friend became the third. This hunt, I had hoped to complete it in his honor.
This is obviously important to you, Umnak. Are you sure you want someone else to take down this machine?
No, I am no longer a match for the claws beneath, if I ever was. If I face it, it will kill me. Of this I have no doubt. The Banuk blood in my veins screams at me to take on the claws myself. But I must see it brought down. And dead men see precious little.
All right, Umnak. I'll do what I can.
I've no doubt you can do quite a lot. The stories say the claws beneath returns here only once every 6 winters. The whispers I've heard say it now makes its home on the northeast edge of the cut. Hunt well.
All right. Plant your feet. Steady.
You.
You're Aloy, right? My pop... Bergrund, I mean, told me you might be heading up to see me. Varja, pleasure. Hey, that spear is really something. You've customized her, haven't you?
I've made a change or two. You've got an eye for weapons.
I wish these Banuk agreed with you. I can't seem to sell scrap to a Glentok around here. Everyone wants boring old bows and spears. I like the more unusual stuff. And the Banuk can get unusual. Like that spear Aratok hauls around? An ice rail. Ooh, or that weapon of Araya's? What I wouldn't give to poke around inside one of those. Feel the lightning on my fingers. Or inside of anything, really. Last commission I had was a month ago. A weapon that spat fire. That didn't go well.
I've got an ice rail, just like Aratok's. You want to take a look?
Are you serious? Yes! Yes! I love that! Okay. Obvious design flaw. So if I replace these... Yeah, that should... Right. So, believe it or not, she's operating at... Let's be generous. Half her potential.
What's with the she's?
Oh. Pop says all weapons are girls. I don't think he realizes it's a compliment. Well, listen. If we had a Thunderjaw's mandibles to work with, her gears would be well and truly greased. And I know where to find one, if you want to go hunting with me.
Remind me what we need to fix up this thing?
That Thunderjaw's mandibles will do it.
So, let's say someone you know happened to have a weapon like Araya's.
You don't!
See for yourself.
Of course! Look at the... So the coils generate the spark, but the power source isn't even bolted in. I won't lie, she's beautiful. But there's beautiful and then there's beautiful. What we need is a Stormbird Talon. Lightning flows over them like water off a goose. And I know where one is. Hunt it with me, I'll turn that weapon into your new best friend. And second best.
You're sure you can fix up this thing?
You bet. Probably. Just need that Stormbird Talon.
A weapon that spits flame, huh? Like this one? I took this thing off an Oseram bandit. Think you could do anything with it?
You got my forge fire back? Well, if you took down Olgrid and his goons for this thing, I guess she's yours now.
Why don't you finish it for me first? Make her into the weapon she was supposed to be.
Thought you'd never ask. I'm gonna need a bellowback snout. Any bellowbacks will do. Can you handle it alone?
I think I can manage that. This forge fire of yours, what do you need to finish it up?
Like I said, a bellowback snout ought to do it. I'm not picky.
So we need parts from a Stormbird and a Thunderjaw? And you know where to find them.
That's right. It's gonna take some traveling, though. We can find a Thunderjaw out in the Valley Meet, and a Stormbird roost near the Free Heat. I'll pack and meet you out there. This'll be fun.
Okay.
Peace and harmony, my friend. So, machines
Long
in the south
well
suffer their own
as you asked.
And our scouts are watching.
I wonder what sort of challenge they present.
Our numbers rise. Three more hunters have passed their trials. But our purpose was to take back the mountain. Now what?
Stay prepared. Sharpen your spears. Should we not return, defending the cut falls to you. If our chieftain agrees with this course.
Sounds like good advice, but let's hope it doesn't come to that.
Chieftain?
The weight of command is no small burden.
I can see that. I take it you haven't spoken to Araya yet?
Why should I? This is what she wanted, to return to Thunder's Drum. It is her only care. So I should have known she would find a way to push aside my spear. After the Karja took my sister, not all of her came back.
What happened to Araya when she was a captive of the Karja?
As a shaman, she's adept with machines, tracking them, stunning them. The Karja used her to capture them for the Sunring, where they were unleashed upon the innocent. They made her part of their blood sport. The shame she suffered beneath their pitiless sun.
She survived.
She endured. Endured by reminding herself of the spirit, her purpose. And now that's all she has.
Tell me what happened to the first expedition.
Araya led the way to the summit, but it was blocked by a great door, some kind of cauldron, new metal. We tried to break through, but it was unflinching. We were exhausted, no way forward and machines behind. I made the call to push back. It cost us greatly. But to remain would have cost us everything. I had hoped to never subject Araya to that again.
What do you think is beyond that door?
I do not know. That expanse of metal, that dead hum. Nothing sacred belongs there. Machines and death, that's what the mountain holds. death for us or for the daemon.
And if we do find the spirit,
then perhaps we should put it out of its misery.
For what it's worth, I'm glad you're coming with me.
Someone has to keep Araya safe.
Karja, murdered in the cut. Last thing we need is more bloodshed. The gold keeps our hunters alert.
Gonna look real good on you.
I never would have made it home without you. Thank you.
I can always use these.
Do you have time to speak? Please come. It'll only take a moment. I'd love to speak with you. I'm alive thanks to you. Let me give you this for your trouble. You have my thanks and the thanks of my family. I never thought I'd get free. Thank you so much.
Praise All Mother. Thank you.
Together.
That should do it. Varja can finish her forge fire now. Tough, but I'm used to it.
You know, I kind of missed all this red dust. Well, there's our Stormbird. When you're ready, I'll follow up and boom.
Let's do this.
Thank you.
Carja said she could improve the Storm Slayer with us.
Go! riding that thing, and it's just allowing it.